For more, let's bring in our Royals expert, Emily Smith, editor of the Page Six column at the New York Post. Let's take a step back to when this all started on Wednesday. The couple put out a statement that said, this is actually on Instagram, so they're going to social media. "We intend to step back as senior members of the royal family and work to become financially independent while continuing to fully support Her Majesty the Queen. We now plan to balance our time between the United Kingdom and North America, continuing to honor our duty to the Queen, the Commonwealth, and our patronages." What's the backstory here?
So the backstory is that Harry had mooted this idea to the Queen and to Prince Charles prior to this, and Charles had said we wanted it in writing. And Harry was worried about that because it might leak, and the Queen had said, look, you know, you have to talk to Charles first, but we have to iron out the details, so let's sit down and all do it and iron out the details. And then on Wednesday, the UK Sun newspaper had some details. In fact, there was a leak, and the Sun got it, and they knew that Harry and Meghan wanted to step down. So when that story came out, then Harry and Meghan decided to go live with their announcement. And the shock was that they only gave the palace 10 minutes with advice that they were going to announce it.
So Buckingham Palace responded to that Instagram posting with this statement: "Discussions with the Duke and Duchess of Sussex are at an early stage. We understand their desire to take a different approach, but these are complicated issues that will take time to work through." Kind of a smackdown, if you will. Buckingham Palace is none too pleased with all
this. No. Reading between the lines there, the Queen is not amused. And, you know, the word is it's complicated. That's the most important part, and it will take time. So, you know, Amy Kellogg just referred to the big meeting that's happening at Sandringham tomorrow. And, you know, how much they can hash out in one day, it'll be difficult. It'll be very difficult.
Harry is back in London for this audience with the Queen, but they've been meeting, or they've been staying in Canada for the last several weeks over the holidays. And you had an exclusive report today in Page Six about who provided this luxury getaway for them. Frank Giustra, a Canadian billionaire.
Yeah, so Frank is a Canadian billionaire and a big philanthropist, but he also has very close ties to the Clintons. Now, what was very interesting about the house was that Harry and Meghan had refused to reveal who had lent them this house and whether they paid for it or not, and they'd been there for more than 6 weeks. And normally with the royals, you're supposed to declare these things because you're not supposed to take, as you say, political favours or personal favours, but they had not said anything at all about it. And so the neighbours started speculating that it was a Russian billionaire, but in fact, it's Frank. He is a very well-known philanthropist. He's very generous. He helps refugees and the homeless. But also he's been mired in some controversy because he's very close to Bill Clinton particularly. In 2005, he went on a trip to Kazakhstan with Clinton and then shortly afterwards announced that he'd invested in three uranium mines in Kazakhstan after meeting with the nation's premier there. His name also came up in the John Podesta emails in 2016 also, having funded a charity for Haiti through the Clinton Foundation.
So how difficult are Meghan and Harry going to find it to try to, you know, earn their own keep and make their own way in the world?
Well, this is going to be the thorniest of all the issues because, like you say, they're not supposed to be political. They're not supposed to have political ties. You know, as royals, they're not supposed to accept gifts. And also, there's certain work that they're not supposed to do. You know, they're not supposed to work for companies. They're not supposed to do paid appearances. And, you know, if they want to be financially independent, if they truly do, they're going to have to do some of those things. So it's what they can negotiate with the Queen and the palace going forward. And again, yes, they have this big meeting with the Queen tomorrow, but I cannot imagine that it'll be settled and sorted and everyone be happy by 5 o'clock, by tea time in the UK.
I believe Harry knows how to fly a helicopter. Those jobs pay pretty well. Perhaps
Indeed.
That's something he can do. Thanks very much, Emily Smith from the New York Post.
Thank you.
Tuesday's Democratic debate.